Hello, everybody. This is a quick video to help you get started using Posit Cloud. After you've made your free account on Posit Cloud, you should see a screen something like this, although maybe you don't have any workspaces yet. If this is your first time, you'll make a new project. And we'll make a new R Studio project. And you'll only need one project for the whole course. We'll put all of our assignments in the same project. That way you can copy code very easily from one assignment to the next. And what we'll be doing throughout the course is building upon what we've done in previous assignments. So first we'll learn basically step one, then step two, then step three, until you're ready to do, maybe a dozen steps and complete your own data analysis. So I'm going to rename this to summer 2023 examples, and you can give your workspace a similar, or your project a similar name. There's a few things to notice when you first log in. First, there's this little window on the left, which you don't need at all. So whenever you log in, you can close it immediately. That just gives you a little bit more space to work with on your computer screen. Next, we'll notice that there's three windows right now. There's a window called the console. We won't be using that today, but later in the course we will. On the right, we have a window called environment, or with a series of other tabs. We're not going to worry too much about the environment today. And on the bottom right, we have a window called files. But you'll see there's a few other tabs here as well. For example, packages is going to be an important one later on in the course. But for now, we want to keep it on files. We'll use files today. Now, the first thing I always encourage students to do when you start working in Posit Cloud is to change the look and feel of it. So if you're happy with the default look and feel, that's fine. But if you want to experiment, then go to Tools, then Global Options, and then a new window will pop up. And here on the left, you're going to select Appearance. And now you can select different themes that you might want to try out. I think I haven't seen Idle Fingers before. iPlastic seems like a new one. There's a lot that you can try out. And if you're really ambitious, you can actually download from the internet custom themes to make it look exactly how you want, or just to try things out, just to mix things up. I think I'm going to go with, I kind of like cobalt today. Let's go with cobalt. So I'm going to select apply, and now my whole screen is in the cobalt theme. All right. Next, we will make a new Quarto document. So almost all of our assignments in this course are going to be Quarto documents. So we'll go File, New File, then Quarto Document. And I'm going to title this Introduce Yourself Assignment. And you can add your name as the author. We're going to output a web page. That's going to be important in the course because we will be submitting almost all of our assignments as web pages. And finally, I'm going to deselect use the visual editor. That way we can just see exactly what we are doing to cause the visual changes that are being shown. So once your dialog window looks like this, you can press create. And now we have a fourth screen, right? So now the console's on the bottom left, environment and files are still on the right, but now on the left side, we have a new editor window. And I'm going to minimize the console by pressing this minimize button. So now I have the whole left side to work or to edit my document. Here I'm getting a little warning that says the package R Markdown is required but not installed. And let's go ahead and install it. Now we can see in this bottom left window, all of these packages are being installed one by one. Now, while that's happening, I want to direct you to the document that we're editing. I'm going to minimize it again, or minimize the console again. And I want you to pay attention to three types of areas in this document. The first is between lines 1 and line 5. So line 1 starts with dash, dash, dash. Line 5 ends with dash, dash, dash. In the middle is this information about the document. So this is sort of the metadata about the document. So we know the title of the document, we know the author of the document, and we know the format that it's being output to. Later in the course, we'll learn some additional metadata we can add to our documents to customize it how we want. But today, we just want to be aware that this metadata is here. And we also want to make a mental note that we should never delete these dashes. These dashes are an important part of the document. They let Posit Cloud know, hey, here's the metadata. Inside here is the metadata. Now from line 6 to 26, this is where we'll do most of our editing, our writing, our programming. So from line 7 to line 14, that's just plain text. It's actually called Markdown. We're going to learn a little bit about Markdown today. But it's just plain text. But from line 15 to 17, this is our code. So you can see it starts with tick, tick, tick. And importantly, that is tick, 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 not apostrophe, apostrophe, apostrophe. So tick, tick, tick. It ends with tick, 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 and we have R in the curly braces. And then you can put any kind of R codes you want between lines 15 and line 17. Here, we're just doing some basic math, 1 plus 1. You can also add, you can do multiplication, or you can do actual R programming, which we will do not today, but in the future. And then finally, in line 26, we're back to just regular code. So before we do anything, let's press this render button. And what render is going to do is, first it's going to ask us to save. So I'll just save this as introduce yourself. But then it's going to create the web page for us. Oh, it wants to open an external window. Let's cancel that. And let's do, I'm going to come up to this gear up here, the settings gear. And I'm going to choose to preview in viewer pane instead of previewing in a window. That way I don't have to worry about pop-ups. And also I'll get to see the web page side by side with the code that produced it. This will help me to understand how the code I'm writing is producing changes in the web page. So again, I'm pressing the gear, then selecting preview in viewer pane. Now when I press render, it should show up in the viewer pane over here, right? So here we go. So this code on the left produces this web page on the right, and we'll be submitting these web pages throughout the course. One thing you'll notice is that some of the text is larger than other areas of the text. For example, the word quarto is nice and large. And when we look at the code on the left, we can see that quarto starts with two hashtags. So you can actually make all kinds of different sized titles. So I'm going to go, we can do level 1, quarto is level 2, let's do level 3, then level 4, and finally, that's not level 4, hold on. Level 4, and then let's do level 5. And now when I press render, we'll see all the different sizes of headings that we can create in code. Okay, so level 1, level 2 has that nice little line under it, level 3, level 4, level 5, and then this is just plain text. So those are some of the options that we have when we're working with the plain text. Those hashtags are markdown syntax, and they let us customize our documents a little bit. The other thing you'll notice on the web page is that the code has a nice little gray background, and the output of the code is below. So 1 + 1 = 2, 2 × 2 = 4, and so on. So you can add code, but we're not going to be doing that today. Today, we're mostly just going to be focusing on learning Markdown. So let's do a couple of things here. First, let's delete everything from line 7 to line 35. Now, the first task in the assignment is to tell the class your name. So you can say, my name is, and I'm going to write Dr. Phils. And your job is to put your name in bold. So in Markdown syntax, you bold things by putting them inside double asterisks. So if I press render, you'll see my name is Dr. Phil. So everything in the double asterisks gets bolded. Then you can tell the class your major. All right, so when I was an undergrad, my major was psychology, perhaps surprising no one. And I'm going to press render, and there's going to be, I believe there will be a small mistake. Let's see what happens. Right? So you can see on the left, I put my major with psychology on line 8. But on the right, it's on the same line as my name is Dr. Phils. And so this is our first little lesson in Markdown. If you want to have a line break, you've got to have two spaces after the last line, after the period there. So now when I press render, it'll be on its own line. So that double spaces trick is going to be an important one. If you're ever wondering, why can't I get this on a separate line? Usually it's the double spaces trick. All right, so next, you got to put your major in italics. All right, so let's do that. So in to get italics, you do single asterisks. So I'm going to render that. And now it will say, my major was psychology, and psychology is in italics. All right, so next, you are required to tell us your three favorite books, or three favorite movies, or three favorite TV shows, or three favorite video games. Let's see here. I'm going to go with my three favorite... let's go with TV shows today. My three favorite TV shows. All right, I'm going to put a couple spaces there. And then I'm going to go, and I think this will work, but we'll see. Sometimes I make mistakes on these too, and you just got to try them out and then fix them afterwards. So I'm going to say three favorite TV shows. Let's see. Right now, definitely Killing Eve. What's another TV show that I... Arcane was a favorite one I had. Oh, it's another good one. I feel like there's so many good TV shows these days. Let's go with, what's come to mind is Better Call Saul. All right, now let's hit render and see if I've done this right, if there's some mistakes. Yeah, I think there's been some mistakes, right? So what I want is I want to see a numbered list like on the right, on the left, right? 1, Killing Eve, 2, Arcane, 3, Better Call Saul. But instead, they're all just together on the same line. So let's fix that. I believe the fix is just adding a line break. So let's render it, and there we go. And so this is going to be a key part of this assignment. Like this assignment is, it's pretty easy overall, you know, just tell us some basic information. But what I'm going to be looking for is that when you ran into a mistake, like I just did, you know, the numbered list isn't showing up like it's supposed to, that, you know, you messed around and you figured it out. You know, you added the line break, you added the double spaces, whatever it needed, you did that. And what I want to see is that not only are these numbers on their own lines, but I want to see there's just a slight indent, right? So that's what happens with the numbered list. You get a slight indent. Okay, finally, you got to tell us one other interesting thing about yourself. So I'll say one other interesting thing about myself is that I'm training to run a marathon in December. All right, and we can press render. There we go. Now, finally, here's a little tricky thing we're going to do today. We are going to insert a photo of ourselves or just any cool photo that you want to share with the class. If you're uncomfortable sharing a photo of yourself. And to do that, you go back to the Files tab and you find this Upload button. So I'm going to press Upload, and now I'm going to choose a file. There we go. And now there is my photo in the Files tab. So that's your main job here. Use the Upload button to upload a photo of yourself. Now it needs to be PNG or GIF or JPEG. As long as you've got a PNG, a GIF, or a JPEG, you'll be fine for the next step. And to insert a photo into the web page, we do exclamation point, square brackets, round brackets, I believe. I might be getting these wrong, but hopefully I'll get this right. So I'm going to write inside the round brackets just the name of the file, which is this. And there it goes. It shows up right there. Inside the square brackets, we can put a little caption. We can say, psychedelic Dr. Phils. And then when we press render, there we go. Oh, I'm not even spelling this right. Let's see here. Maybe like this. We'll see. Okay. But that's how you get a picture into your web page. So again, how it was I went to Files, I press Upload, I uploaded the photo, I see the photo in my Files tab, and then I just type this sort of weird line, but this is just how you do it in Markdown. It's exclamation point, square brackets, round brackets. And now you have your introduce yourself assignment. And if you have any questions, email me or rewatch the video. But again, I'm just looking to see that you know how to add bold, have line breaks, add italics. Can you do a numbered ordered list like this? And can you insert a photo?